Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Since the beginning of this course, you've been studying matter at a very small scale, considering the atoms and molecules that make up substances, and learning to predict their behavior. We're now ready to shift our focus to the larger parts of the physical world, and we'll be focusing on objects that you can actually see. This part of the course will give you an introduction to the subject of physics. What comes to mind when you think of physics? Lots of complicated math equations, maybe some famous scientists? Math is definitely an important part of physics, but in this course we'll focus more on the concepts and keep the numbers to a minimum. We will definitely learn about some really smart scientists, though. But before we dig in, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to explain how speed is used to describe motion, and list the properties that contribute to momentum and kinetic energy. We're going to start our study of physics with motion. And when we think of motion, fast things tend to come to mind. What's the fastest thing you can think of? A sprinter? A race car? A spaceship? In November of 2022, you may remember watching the launch of NASA's first Artemis mission to the moon. The Orion spacecraft achieved a launch speed of over 17,000 miles per hour. For reference, a typical car on a highway travels around 70 miles per hour. This might make Orion's launch speed seem unmatchable. But did you know that it's not even the fastest man-made object? Another spacecraft, NASA's Parker Solar Probe, which is studying the Sun, will spend parts of its orbit traveling at nearly 430,000 miles per hour. That makes Artemis's 17,000 miles per hour look pretty pokey. These examples show us that immense speed is definitely possible. These speeds I've just given you were in miles per hour. If you live in the US, this is probably the unit of speed most familiar to you. But remember that in science, we like to use metric units when possible, and miles are definitely not metric. So, when looking up the speed of spacecraft, you might find that instead of being stated as 430,000 miles per hour, the solar probe's speed is given as 692,000 kilometers per hour, or even 191 kilometers per second. See how all of the units for speed have one unit for distance and one unit for time? Because speed is a measure of how much distance is covered in a given amount of time. Have you ever seen a huge truck come barreling down the highway toward you? They can be pretty intimidating. Any idea what makes large, fast objects seem scary? Scientifically, we would describe this as momentum or kinetic energy. You see, both momentum and kinetic energy tell us something about both the mass and speed of an object. In later lessons in this unit, we'll look at the difference between momentum and kinetic energy. But for now, it's enough to know that they both increase as objects get bigger and faster. And both can lead to dramatic results when large, fast objects collide. Have you ever seen a Newton's cradle? This simple desktop toy is a great way to see how the kinetic energy and momentum of a moving object can be transferred to another object. As one of the moving balls strikes a stationary ball, it transfers its kinetic energy and momentum, causing the next ball to move. But it probably can't move far because there is another stationary ball on the other side of it. So the kinetic energy and momentum gets passed all the way down the line until it reaches the ball on the end, which ends up mirroring the movement of the first ball. Without the friction from air resistance, this motion would repeat back and forth forever. Interactions of moving objects like these will be the topic of our first physics unit, so that you can have the tools you need to describe motion, which is one of the most fundamental properties of our world. After all, can you think of anything that is not moving? You might be thinking, me, right now, I'm sitting down watching this video, not moving at all. Well, I've got news for you. You are never truly still. Remember in a previous unit when we talked about the motion of atoms? They are always vibrating, and the atoms, molecules, and cells that make up your body are always in motion to keep you alive. But there's more. You and everything else on Earth is always in motion around the sun at a whopping 107,000 kilometers per hour. So the ability to accurately describe and measure motion is pretty important. As we went through the lesson today, you got a very brief preview of some of the topics that we'll be studying in this unit on motion. We can measure motion with speed using a variety of units. We can also think about motion in terms of an object's momentum and kinetic energy, which depend on mass as well as speed. As we go through the unit, you'll want to complete the notes and activities in the lesson PDF. The PDF for the entire unit is attached to this lesson, so this is a good time to go ahead and get it downloaded or print it out. Next time, we'll take a closer look at the properties of position, distance, and displacement. These may not be motion themselves, but are necessary to be able to measure motion. Until then, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.